Oliver, the decarbonization of buildings is a massive challenge, but it's absolutely necessary to reach our energy and climate goals to reduce emissions. And the heat transition is extremely important to achieve that goal. How do you see this from your perspective at the Building Performance Institute? What do you think are the major opportunities, the major hurdles there?
I think it is absolutely essential that we bring the decarbonization of the supply, of the heating supply, together with a demand reduction in the building's side, to align the two things, to not think them separately. That would be a major disaster if we try to develop solutions in silos. I think we need to make sure that the demand reduction is empowered also by decarbonizing the heating supply. And that means that we need to develop not individualized decarbonization heating plans and renovation plans, but that we need to bring renovation plans together with decarbonizing heating supply. Yeah? So we really need to think in alignment, in connection, and that is the biggest challenge, because you need to bring industry planning together with the planning of individual municipalities or individual building owners or larger real estate investors. So we need to bridge gaps which are currently there to have more effective and faster transformation of the built environment.
And we also have a massive opportunity to do so now, because we have all those different policies now being agreed upon between the energy performance of buildings, the Energy Efficiency Directive, Renewable Energies Directive. I mean, there are a lot of parts to the puzzle, I think, which we can use to make this happen.
Absolutely. In the last 5 years, we have achieved an enormous amount of new legislative initiatives in Europe, to which all the member states have agreed. And now the ball is basically in the court of the member states to implement these agreements into national law, to really have the right regulations, the right incentive schemes in place, that the transformation is happening. And that's the unique opportunity, because we have found a political consensus, a political agreement across Europe. And so the member states, together with industry, together with citizens, together with civil society, have the big opportunity to translate into action and to really improve our built environment and decarbonize our built environment and fight energy poverty, and in the end, have a much better living environment for every European citizen.
That's a very nice way to end this. Thank you so much, Oliver.
Thank you very much, Andrea.